Ladies and gentlemen, Christmas in Washington with the United States Naval Academy Glee Club, the Shiloh Gospel Choir, the St. Columba Children's Choirs, and starring Julio Iglesias, Leslie Uggams, and Andy Williams.
Oh, we go. Christmas bells are ringing, caroling, caroling through the snow. Christmas bells are ringing, joyous voices sweet and clear. Sing the sad of heart to cheer. Ding dong, ding dong, Christmas bells are ringing. Ding dong, ding dong, Christmas bells are ringing. Town. Christmas bells are ringing, caroling, caroling up and down. Christmas bells are ringing, mark thee well the song we sing. Gladsome tidings now we bring. Ding dong, ding dong, Christmas bells are ringing. Ding dong, ding dong, Christmas bells are ringing.
Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong.
Caroling, caroling.
Ding dong, ding dong.
Caroling, 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 near and far, Christmas bells are ringing, following, following yonder star, Christmas bells are ringing.
Christmas bells are ringing.
Sing we all this happy morn, born. Ding dong, ding dong, Christmas bells are ringing. Ding dong, ding dong, Christmas bells are Christmas in Washington. It's an honor for me and for all of the members of the cast to perform in such an historic building with such a distinguished audience. We are at the National Building Museum, the site of many inaugural balls over the years. The sounds of cheers and social dancing give way tonight to the sounds of Christmas, carols and gospel melodies, songs of inspiration from other lands, and choirs, both brass and vocal, to the herald the birth of the baby Jesus. During the course of the evening, we'll also learn of the colorful history and tradition associated with Christmas in this, our nation's capital, over the past two centuries. Our storytellers are persons of high esteem, and the tales they have to tell are as varied and interesting as the inhabitants of this remarkable city and the residents of the house at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. You've already heard from the wonderful United States Naval Academy Glee Club, but in Washington, we all agree you can't have too much of a good thing. So we call on them again to be joined by the St. Columba Choir, the bell ringers, the beautiful Leslie Uggams, and the equally beautiful Julio Iglesias, for a medley of bipartisan Christmas songs that can be appreciated by those on either side of the aisle. Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, let's go. Let's look at the show. We're riding in a wonderland of snow. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, it's grand. Just holding your hand.
We're riding along with a song.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. On the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to laugh and sing the sleighing song tonight.
Whoa, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse sleigh.
I'm dreaming of the white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the tree tops listen and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of the white Christmas, with every Christmas card arrive. May your days be merry and bright, and may
sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the
season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight.
They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh.
And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And
so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92.
Though it's been said many times, many ways,
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Through the years, we all will be together. If the fates allow, so hang a shining star upon the highest bar. A merry little Christmas now.
A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight, walking in the winter wonderland. We'll sing our song as we go along, walking in the winter wonderland.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Oh, we need a little Christmas, right this very minute.
Television journalist. He's covered the Washington scene for many years, and he was nice enough to come here to share some of his observations of Christmas in Washington. Here is Roger Mudd.
Washington, D.C. has always taken a special comfort and pleasure in Christmas. So many families are here on temporary duty and their roots are elsewhere that the city's celebration of Christmas draws us all closer together. All of us take delight in watching the national Christmas tree being raised and lighted. Each one of us looks forward to seeing our White House festooned and ribboned. On Capitol Hill, where 11 months a year a Christmas tree is really a tax bill, the Congress is actually decorating a real tree at Christmas time, and this year it's a 50-foot spruce from Wisconsin. Of course, it was a tax bill that brought Joseph and Mary to Bethlehem almost 2,000 years ago. We all know the story the way St. Luke wrote it. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. Because of this decree that everyone was to be taxed in his own city, Joseph set off for the city of David, which was called Bethlehem, to be taxed with his wife, Mary. And so it was, while they were there, she brought forth her firstborn son. and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Nobody seems likely to claim that because we are in the city where taxes originate and where it is winter and where most of the inns are filled, that there will be born to us a savior. But all of us do claim that the spirit of the Nativity is very much alive here. Throughout the years, America's presidents have helped keep that spirit alive. In fact, a history of America could be written from the Christmas messages of our presidents, reflecting not only the American condition, but also the depth of our leaders' faith. In the midst of the Great Depression, Herbert Hoover said, "Christmas is the children's day, and older folk can enter into its joy only when led by their hands." Just a few days after Pearl Harbor, Franklin Roosevelt said, "Our strongest weapon in this war is that conviction of dignity and brotherhood of man which Christmas Day signifies." In 1948, Harry Truman, in his unassuming way, said, "I have come out here to Independence, Missouri, to celebrate the great home festival. For of all the days of the year, Christmas is the family day. Christmas began that way." In 1959, Dwight Eisenhower, just back from a trip around the world, said, "I fervently hope that in this Christmas season, each of you will give thought to what you can do for another human, identical with you in his divine origin and destiny, however distant in miles and poor in worldly estate." And less than a year before he died, John Kennedy said, "Christmas is truly the universal holiday of all men, when all are reminded that mercy and compassion are the enduring virtues, when all show, by small deeds and large, that it is more blessed to give than to receive." And few of us can forget the Christmas of 1979, when we prayed for the 50 American hostages in Iran, or the Christmas of 1981, when we lighted our candles in our windows as a beacon of solidarity for the Polish people. So the good news is that the spirit of the Nativity is alive in Washington. May your Christmas tree be as sturdy as faith, as high as hope, as wide as love, as beautiful as peace. Of course, nothing is more beautiful than the sweet sounds of Christmas. Let's listen to them now, interpreted by the gospel choir of the Shiloh Baptist Church and the glorious voice of Leslie Uggams.
Angel,
by the angel,
born in a manger, Lord. listen. Come on and listen. You ought to listen. Come on and listen. You got to listen. Come on and listen. You got to listen. Come on and listen. Come on and listen. Why don't you listen?
From the tiniest town to the largest urban metropolis, the celebration of Christmas takes place all over America. The customs that accompany this holiday are as varied as the people who make up our great country. Here in the nation's capital, the spirit of Christmas is alive and well. And if you drive down Pennsylvania Avenue, you'll see tiny white lights on the trees in front of the White House. It's a place rich with tradition. And here to share some of its history is the lady of the house, Mrs. Nancy Reagan.
It's been said that every American has two homes, his own and the White House. And the spirit of excitement and anticipation that exists in almost every home around Christmas is also very much in evidence around here. Just as any home through the years takes on characteristics of the people who live there, so the White House has reflected the tastes and attitudes of its residents over the past two centuries. The White House wasn't built until after George Washington's term in office. And when John Adams moved into this house in November 1800, only six rooms were furnished. 13 fires were kept going all day just to ward off the dampness. Nevertheless, the Adams family inaugurated the custom of the White House Christmas parties for children. And their warmth more than made up for the dampness in the house. Thomas Jefferson played his violin as his six grandchildren wandered through the 100 or so guests at his Christmas reception. Andrew Jackson, who reportedly never had a toy as a child, felt very strongly about making holiday a delight for the children, and threw a huge party which ended in a snowball fight in the state dining room. Fortunately, the snowballs were only cotton. When Theodore Roosevelt and his family took up residence here, he banned Christmas trees in the White House because he believed cutting down so many evergreens would injure the American forest. Of course, he was furious when he learned that two of his sons had secretly slipped a tree into their room. The boys called on a forestry expert who pointed out that selective cutting of evergreens would actually aid the forest, and the president allowed the tree to remain. And it was Franklin Roosevelt who on Christmas night would gather the family together and read Dickens' A Christmas Carol, playing all the parts himself. This old house has seen its share of joys and pleasures, triumphs and tragedies. But probably the happiest sights and sounds come from children gathered here to celebrate Christmas. Our prayer is that this year and for all years to come, your home and ours will echo with a sound of love and joy at Christmas time.
Stille Nacht, heilige Nacht, Engel, Engel. da velando ser un pobre porta a un infante de amor celestial. Llegan todos al cielo, vivan los pueblos en paz.
Thought it only fair that they have equal representation here tonight. I'd like you all to meet a young friend of mine. Her name is Midori. Midori comes from Osaka, Japan, and began studying the violin at the age of 4 years old with her mother. She is now all of 12 and is a student of Dorothy DeLay at the famous Juilliard School in New York. In her short career, she has already appeared as a soloist with the Osaka Symphony, the Philadelphia Orchestra, and the New York Philharmonic. When I was your age, I was still trying to learn the spinning song on the piano. Anyway, we're delighted to have you here with us tonight to play one of the most technically difficult pieces ever written for the violin, the Caprice No. 1 by Paganini. Ladies and gentlemen, Midori.
Thank you.
Some children see him lily white, the baby Jesus born this night. Some children see him lily white, with tresses soft and fair. Some children see him bronzed and brown, the Lord of heaven to earth come down. Some children see him bronzed and brown, with dark and heavy. Some children see him almond-eyed, the Savior whom we kneel beside. Some children see him almond-eyed, with skin of yellow. Some children see him dark as day, and they love him too. The children in each different place will see the baby Jesus' face like theirs, but bright with heavenly grace and filled with holy light. Oh, lay aside each earthly thing and with thy heart as offering come. The infant king, 'tis love that's born Israel.
still we see thee lie above thy deep and dreamless sleep. The silent stars go by, yet in thy dark street shine the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight.
Adeste fidelis, leti triumphante, venite, venite in Bethlehem. Natum videte, regie angelo. Venite adoremus, venite adoremus, venite adoremus, us
The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh hear the angel voices, oh with the stirring sounds of Christmas still ringing in our ears and in our hearts, it is my honor to introduce the man for whom the phrase, peace on earth, has the greatest significance, the President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan.
Thank you very much. Nancy and I want to thank you for inviting us here tonight. We've thoroughly enjoyed ourselves, as I know all of you have. And Andy Williams, I think we'll have to declare your voice a national treasure. Andy. Andy is someone who exemplifies the best ideals of the entertainment industry. We can all be grateful that he's been around to gladden our hearts and to add meaning to an occasion like this one tonight. We can also be grateful for the fine young people of the United States Naval Academy. This chorus has lifted our spirits and made us very proud. You young people in that chorus are training at Annapolis so that one day you will be preserving the peace. During this holiday season, I hope that all of us will take time to remember in our prayers the dedicated men and women in our military forces. It is especially hard for them away from home during this holiday season, but they've taken on a heavy responsibility. Let us also pray that someday we can build a world where young men and women aren't needed to stand guard, because the spirit of Christmas will have been made a reality. The Christmas spirit is a candle that we must always keep burning. Nancy and I wish each of you a very happy holiday season. And again, we thank all these wonderful people here, these children, the young people, this choir, all of them, for what they have brought to us tonight. God bless them all, and God bless you.
Christmas in Washington has been brought to you by AT&T. The more you-